Today I'm reading a script off my teleprompter here, and I'm hoping that this is going to work flawlessly and it'll be all done in one take. That is very unlikely. Also, my eyes may be a little bit like this. I haven't done this that many times. Let's start over. Connection bonding. What is it? What are the options? And which is the best one for you as an IRL live streamer? These are just a few of the questions I plan to answer for you in today's video. Let's start by exploring what connection bonding is and what it isn't. Bonding for us means adding one or more Wi-Fi or maybe Ethernet connections to strengthen your existing upload speeds. That way you'll have a faster and more reliable broadcast for you and your viewers. Faster speeds means you can bump up your resolution, frame rate, and all the other things I talk about in this other video. Link in the description if you'd like to know more. As for what connection bonding isn't, it's not a wand that can magically fix how good or bad your live stream looks. It can help, but it's just one part of a larger puzzle. Seriously, check out that other video. It also can't fix every connection issue you might have. For example, if you're bonding two SIM cards from the same mobile provider, but there's no signal in the area for your provider, then your bonded connection is, as they say. That's where a backup plan like disconnect protection can save your live stream from ending early. Okay, with that out of the way, let's go over some of the bonding options I've tried, starting with Speedify. Available for Android and iOS, it's a premium service which includes a VPN. They have a free account with 2 GB of usage before you'd have to upgrade. This should be enough for you to test it out with maybe an hour or two of live streaming in one go. You can use this toggle button to turn it on and off when you do and don't need it, which is handy because that 2 GB won't last long. In my tests, I saw the best results when the main phone was connected to the Wi-Fi of a dedicated hotspot, and to be honest, pretty disappointing results when connected to the hotspot of a second phone, which is the scenario I'd be using as an IRL live streamer with two phones. Granted, this was a while ago and might be different now, especially with their new peer and share feature, which according to them shares the cellular connections between multiple Speedify users on the same Wi-Fi network. This sounds great for families and businesses, but as a solo live streamer, maybe I'm missing something. If you're using Speedify as your primary bonding service, I'd love to hear from you. The second option is BOS Cloud in combination with SRT LA and one of two IRL live streaming apps, IRL Pro and Moblin. I've talked about it before in one of my other videos, but here's basically how it works. You sign into your BOS Cloud account, import the connection info for your phone, whether that's IRL Pro for Android or Moblin for iOS. Connect your phone's Wi-Fi to the hotspot of your other phone or dedicated device, and you're good to go. Of course, there's more to it than that, but from what I can tell, upload speeds from a hotspot and phone seem to be about the same. Link in the description if you'd like to know more about that one. Next option is free, and is for anyone who's been following my IRL live streaming series for beginners, have managed to get port forwarding to work, and have IRL Pro as your primary streaming phone. That app also supports bonding without SRT LA. Just go into the settings, bonding, where you can enable bonding for the connections listed. If you scroll down the page, there's options for the weighting of your cellular and Wi-Fi connection, so have a look around and give it a go. Finally, you can send your phone's broadcast into an IRL backpack like a Bella Box or LiveView, where it's bonded to one or more modems. I've done this by sending an RTMP signal out from my phone into a Bella Box, which was bonded with two modems. The specifics I won't get into right now because it could be a whole other video on its own, but it's another way of getting it done, although a little excessive. Okay, so out of all these options, which one do I think is the current champion for IRL live streamers? For me right now, that award goes to BOS Cloud and SRT LA, and here's why. It's available for Android and iOS. Also, you're sorted if you ever get the hardware for an IRL backpack. For BOS Cloud, bonding is like an added bonus. It doesn't take any extra work to enable it. Now, IRL Pro without SRT LA is a close second because it's free, but unfortunately for iPhone owners, it's for Android only. So if there was an app available for both platforms that provided a similar bonding service without SRT LA, I guess we'll see. So do you agree with me? Did I leave something out? Let me know in the comments. Now let's say you've got bonding to work perfectly. What's next? Well, how about controlling your live stream with chat commands? Chat commands that can switch to almost any scene you want, or a way to activate filters or overlays in a specific order. I'll be covering how to do this in one of these videos right here. This video for PC owners, and this one for Mac and PC. Please like and subscribe to the video if you found it helpful. Thanks for watching. I'll see you over there. or maybe over there.